I'm standing in for Dr. Josephine, who is away, and she wasn't able to be with us. So I was called in from the field as to help have the session go through. Basically, we're talking about community engagement being very important in curbing health threats at their sources. So I'll use Uganda Red Cross as an example. So we know very well that the problems start and end in the communities. Okay? So our leverage is that as Uganda Red Cross or as the International Federation of Red Cross Societies, country in the whole world, we have this unique aspect of being within the communities, because we select our volunteers from the communities and we train these volunteers to be able to train their community members and also be able to mobilize them when there's response. So as Uganda Red Cross, we realize that it is far better to be involved in preparedness. So preparedness means that the One Health concepts will have to apply. So I do not have to explain what the One Health concepts are. So basically, what we're doing in terms of having community engagement is that we work with volunteers, train them, they train the communities, improve their health literacy. So this has given advantages that I'll show you. So when we deal with communities and we give them the right information in a timely matter, in a timely manner, and they participate in decisions that affect their health, they report to us when they have issues in the community. So what am I alluding to here? In global health security, we're basically talking about early detection, early action. So for epidemic prone diseases, I can use a case study of Ebola. So what happens is that our volunteers that are in the communities is are trained. So we have the International Federation of the Red Cross and Red Crescent Societies that has curricula such as epidemic control for volunteers, community-based health and first aid, community-based surveillance, and all other WASH-related curriculum. So having this chest of information, we, in a participatory manner, do trainings with the local government officials. So we go, let's say, to a district like Kasese. We pick people from the district leadership. We go and train together the community volunteers. So how does this help by involving leadership? So in leadership, so we can also have technical leadership, political leadership in the districts. So we have a chest of the curriculum. We use the participatory approach. We go down to the communities. We select our volunteers. They are taught on how to do epidemic control. They are taught how to effectively communicate with their fellow community members. So here's where the work starts. We have trained volunteers doing risk communication, doing health promotion, and applying the One Health concept. So having been armed with this information and the health literacy of the community is improving. When community members, having learned various signs and symptoms, are able to report in real time to the volunteers that, hey, there is someone here with unusual bleeding and fever. So they go and interrogate very quickly, then pass on the information to Uganda Red Cross at the various levels. So with this information,
we are able to work with government to quickly respond and snuff out any epidemic prone diseases. So the topic today is about community engagement and government engagement in One Health. So ours is through participatory approach, using information as aid, social behavior change, and advocacy. We raise the voices of the communities. So that is what I